A very controversial picture trended on Facebook. It's a picture of a couple that tried to kidnap a kid. Now, they were found by the community and were mobbed almost to death. Now, there's been controversial reactions to this. People are saying this is good, and some people are saying it is bad because mob justice is bad for our society. I'm going to say this is good because it's a step in the right direction, considering that people are now vigilant and are aware of what's happening around them. On the show this evening, we are talking about this and the State of the Nation address. So sit back and let's have this conversation. On Wednesday this week, the President of Uganda, His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, delivered the State of the Nation address. And among the things he talked about was corruption and the rampant kidnap of women. Now on the show this evening, I have Eric, who is also a trying blogger. Am I right?
Yeah, you're right.
And I have Ophelia Kemigisha, who is a human rights lawyer. Guys, welcome to the show.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
How are your timelines this week?
Very busy, very political. A lot of advocacy. Yeah. And I'm happy about it so far.
Did you see Sevo's picture? The one with the flowers, and he looked like he's on Snapchat.
He tried to be a slave king somewhere. I saw the picture. It was a good shot. I would credit the person that took it.
Just before the show, I said he looked younger. You said he looked older.
Did you see the eyes?
Yeah, he looked like he's 45.
He looked very tired.
Ophelia, how old would you give the president in that picture?
President is young, guys. Where do you want to say bad things about
how
the
old is
president?
He? How old is he?
He's young.
Now, let's start with the rampant kidnaps. It's now like common knowledge. It's every week we have a story out of a woman has been kidnapped, a kid has been kidnapped, and of recently people are kidnapping themselves. Mm. You understand? So, let's start from there. Where do you think, as a lawyer, the problem is?
I think it's many things. Of course, we know that when stories like kidnap go out. Of course, because there's a lot of desperate people in the country, maybe they get encouraged to also try it. So maybe covering it and the kind of traction it's getting may be part of the problem. But I think the bigger problem is that I don't feel like our police takes the matter seriously. Last year, 23 women were murdered in Entebbe. We haven't seen people produced in court. Yes, the murder has stopped, but we don't know what that means. This year, it's just like one case after another. And of course, yes, some people kidnap themselves, and police likes to say that, some people kidnap themselves, let's talk about those. But the truth is that a lot of us are honestly terrified. If you get online and you just read like three stories of people getting kidnapped, we're always terrified. And I think that the reason for the kind of, as you said, there's a lot of advocacy on the TL Women's March, and it was just to bring attention to the issue and hope that they can take it more seriously, and hopefully we can feel safer.
In your opinion, do you think this is just about women?
No, I don't think it's just about women. It's just that women have been they've been more vulnerable to the kidnaps and obviously for obvious reasons, because they're just generally a vulnerable group. And I think the problem is that we don't feel, personally, I don't think that this kind of lukewarm reaction would be like that if it was 36 men. I don't think that would be a thing.
Eric, what do you think? You think if the numbers were favoring the men, if there were more men kidnapped than women, that, you know, the reaction would be wild?
I think there's been a tendency in our security organs to react to things that go down to the woman. Every time it's women something, the police, the security organs take time to react to this. And the women came in because they're like, hey, this has been happening and we don't see anything being done. So they stood up for their rights and like, hey, let's meet the police boss and maybe we can form a dialogue and see how we can better our rights, how we can stop these murders and kidnaps.
Now, of course, they delivered a letter to the IGP.
The letter was delivered, but the dialogue didn't happen.
It wasn't delivered.
So the letter wasn't delivered and the dialogue didn't happen. So they want this dialogue. So I don't see a reason in that for police to stop them. They should really meet these people. If it's a thing that targets our mothers, our sisters, our daughters, so why shouldn't police meet them if they think they can have a solution to it? if they can contribute.
Someone tweeted and said an alternative group of youth activists dropped a coffin at Parliament protesting kidnap and murder of women and children. They say Parliament has neglected the issue to enjoy salary. This is a tweet. But don't you think police was right? I mean, someone is dropping a coffin at Parliament. If they had, you know, allowed you guys to freely and according to the law, express your freedom, you know, have your freedom of expression, you probably would have dropped, I don't know, worse than a coffin.
Did you follow the events on Twitter?
I did.
So you saw that the women came and went to the Human Rights Commission. They were unarmed, right? So police has, like I said, police has all the power. When you have the power, you have the responsibility. They had one job. They could have just been like, okay, you guys are too many. You're 30 and you're singing and we don't want noise in our area, right? So send 3 people. Let them come in. Let's have a conversation. Give you feedback and then you go home. You see, everybody would have gone home peacefully. Instead, the 2 people who offered themselves up to have a conversation were arrested. And everybody else who... At one point, I was at the scene and somebody came with a placard and their mouth taped and they just bundled him into a truck. You see, you can't stop people from expressing themselves. Just imagine you're just there and they're like, I don't like your shirt, take it. You get, like, it doesn't make sense. If you have the power, you have the responsibility. So you don't, like, activism is not a crime. You just have to reassure them and tell them, guys, we are doing our best. Please be patient. Because their fears are not unfounded. Yeah.
Eric, let me come to you. We've had, you know, a number of protests in the, you know, years back and they've grown. And in your own opinion, do you think that police is trying to understand the way that, you know, Uganda is headed, that, you know, people can get out of their homes and go and protest about something? Do you think that police handled this better than it had handled similar issues in the past?
From when you take it from the legal front, police has actually tried to make sure people don't express themselves. That's when the Kayihura's regime campaigned for the untriot, and they called it actually... Right now, if you start a riot, you'd be taken in as a terrorist. You're not seen as a person trying to fight for their rights. So police has not really tried to understand people. It has gone to the point of they try to force people to stay calm. They want to show that if they tell you that you are not supposed to cross that line and you stay that side, they've done their job. So police has not tried to come down and sort criminal activity, prevent kidnaps, murder, theft or anything. All they look at is, are we protecting government's interests? Is Museveni feeling okay where he is? So the moment you try to put up any protest, however simple it might be, you remember what happened to Black Monday, the walk to work, something that was just people walking to work. This police decided to arrest
them. The numbers were becoming unmanageable.
Yeah, but to their credit, they said they didn't tear gas anybody.
Yeah, oh, that wasn't...
So it's kudos for police. They handled...
Let's just say, maybe Ocholla is trying to move away from that Kayihura kind of business. Because if it was Kayihura, trust me, you guys would have been tear gassed already. You guys would have been tear gassed 2 minutes into your...
Can't we have other means of, you know, having this done? And of course, considering that you went to police, was police the right institution to, you know, have this kind of dialogue with?
I don't know. What do you suggest?
I'm thinking you'd have gone to probably Parliament. This guy's passed the laws. This guy's, you know, handle all this. The police moves under the law, so.
But the law does not investigate crime, you see. The problem is that we feel like that there's a gap in the investigation of crime, and that's police's job. So I think it was the best possible avenue. Yeah, and we have another match coming up, by the way. So you should come. I'm inviting you personally. I'm inviting you in June. Yeah, join
okay,
us.
Let's head for a short break. And when we get back, I'm going to give you a response. And say I'll come or not come. But I'm for the women. I'm saying this is too. It's becoming too much. So after a short break, we'll talk this and some of the trends, including State of the Nation address.